Entrepreneur Magazine says COVID-19 didn't kill your business, you did. That's what we're going to talk about today. Welcome to How to Build a Tent. My name is Matt Williams. Thank you for listening to the show, sharing the show, subscribing on the YouTube if you are watching on there. I really appreciate all of you guys and all the great feedback that we get for the show. I'm just so blessed to be able to talk with you guys almost every day and hear about how God has blessed you guys and what God is doing in your lives. Please keep on sharing those with me. You can direct message me, email me, matt@howtobuildatent.com. Go over to Phi Laugh Feast Network, put in the code HTBT, and you will get a sweet mug. You'll get a discount on $100 off our, I always want to say convention, but it's not a convention. It's a conference. And that's Nashville, 1st through the 3rd, October. October 1st through the 3rd. Go over there, get that $100 off, get the t-shirt, get the mug, and get tons of exclusive content only for club members. It's absolutely fantastic. Toby is doing a great little course, I guess, on work. I highly recommend that as well. Go over there. FLFnetwork.com, HGBT. Put that in there, and you will get all the good stuff. All right, so why would entrepreneur.com write an article, COVID-19 didn't kill your business, you did? Why does Phil LaDuke, who says this, which under the tagline, he says companies that were doing a poor job before the pandemic aren't likely to survive. And I would just, my wife actually sent this to me, my lovely wife. Why would Entrepreneur Magazine write this article? Because no doubt who their customer base is, you guessed it, entrepreneurs, startup companies. And who, if you had to guess, what size of a business probably didn't survive the most out of this whole coronavirus situation? Small businesses, startups, people that are reading Entrepreneur Magazine. I guarantee you the publicly traded companies do not have much or many readers or interest in Entrepreneur Magazine. But these are specifically, there are these publications, these articles are specifically written for the entrepreneur, the startup, the people that are most likely listening to the show. So why write it? Why write it? Well, I first want to make this differentiation again, because I feel like I'm the only one who says this sometimes. I don't hear a lot of other people saying this. COVID-19 didn't kill your business, even if what he's saying is true. The government killed your business by making these mandatory shutdowns, making these mandatory requirements on your business, and nothing to do with the virus. In fact, the data was so poor that we had no business doing what we did. We had no business doing what we did, that is, quarantining the healthy. But we're just gonna leave that on the side for now. I just want you to remember that the coronavirus didn't kill your customers. The coronavirus didn't make your customers so sick they couldn't come in. People were told they could not come in. They told you your businesses couldn't open. They're telling you how to run your business, how many people can be in your lobby, how many people can be eating at your tables, how many people, how many workers you can have. All of those things are the government changing the game, making rules that are making it harder for you to be successful. And in fact, for you startups, for you entrepreneurs, reading entrepreneur.com, some of these are insurmountable. And a lot of you will most likely have to go out of business unless you have been able to find a way to pivot, to transform, to be able to innovate in a way where you are relevant and providing value. And we've had many shows about this before, which feels like years ago, but was really only in March. We talked about different restaurants that were pivoting, that were selling frozen food, and they were buying wholesale meats back when there was a meat shortage, which meat is still really expensive, by the way. We did our first quarter cow, or 16th cow, I forgot what size we got, but we did our first cow purchase. I wasn't really happy with it, I'm gonna be honest, guys. I like the fresh, thick cut, and then they come frozen, and it's thin. I wasn't happening with that. So if you guys actually do go and buy cows, buy quarter cows, 16th cows, or whatever you buy them in, and you do like it, and you find that you can get the thick cut meat, and it's fresh, and all that stuff, I'd love to have a little, you know, insider knowledge, insider tips, so I can get in on that action. Otherwise, I'm just gonna be going back to butcher shops. But the meats were going up in price. And so what I was saying was that we talked about before about finding ways to pivot and how restaurants were doing more things, like they were selling napkins, selling toilet paper back when there was a shortage and things like that. But why write this article? And it's interesting because he goes on and he talks about from chain restaurants that I wouldn't frequent on a bet to once mighty retailers that are a shadow of their former glory. Now, these aren't startups. Chain restaurants and once mighty retailers are not entrepreneurs. They're not the ones starting new businesses. They're not the ones that are going to be reading these things. They're not the ones that have small businesses. These are actually large businesses, the mighty retailers, the chain restaurants. So I ask you, why are they writing this article? Why are they publishing this man's opinion? And this is why, and this is what I wanted to talk about, and this is what kind of infuriates me, is it's part of the narrative. It's, guys, we had this big government program, we had these command style economy, we had the government come in and tell you what to do, and we ruined you. We put you out of business. We put down all these regulations. We told you what you should and shouldn't provide, that what you should or shouldn't sell. We even have price gouging laws where we told you what you could sell it for and not, what prices you could sell your products for or not. We've done everything in the past 2 to 3 months, in effect, that the left and progressives, which Entrepreneur Magazine is a left-leaning publication, we've done everything that we've ever wanted to do, what we told you would be fair, what we told you would work out better for you, how we would take care of the little guy, the small business, the everyday man. We did it all. We had government intervention. We had government command style economy. We told you what to produce, how much to produce it at, where you could sell your products, where you couldn't sell your products, when you could be open, when you couldn't be open, how many people you could sell to, how many people you couldn't sell to. We did everything. And you went out of business. And you lost revenue. And you lost customers. You needed us to bail you out. But it's not really COVID-19's fault / the government. You are the problem. You are probably gonna go out of business anyways. You're the problem. You were doing a poor job, and that is why you couldn't survive the US economy shutting down for, what is it, 90 days now? More than that, that's 3 months. What are we at now? It's March, April, May, June, July, August, 6 months. It's your fault. It's your fault that you couldn't survive 6 months. In fact, it was probably because you were doing a poor job. And do you see the spin here? This is just like an abusive relationship, guys. You know, you see it in the movies all the time. And I'm sure it's probably how it happens in real life. I have never been a wife that's been beaten by men. But in the movies, they always have these situations where the wife is being abused, battered, beaten, black eyes, has to cover it up with makeup. And what does the husband always do in the movies? They blame the wife. Oh, it's your fault. You make me so angry. And this is what's happening. It's the government and the authoritarians, the progressives, that are getting everything they want. They're telling you what to buy, how much to sell it for, who you could sell it for, how often you could sell it for, all of these things. And they ran you out of business. And they cut into your profits. And they made you foreclose on your property, on your lease agreement. They've made you bankrupt. But it's not their problem. It's your fault. It was you who didn't have a business that would survive 6 months of an economic shutdown by the government. What's wrong with you? You're a terrible entrepreneur. You're a terrible small businessman. It's definitely not our fault. It's definitely not our progressive policies that have run you out of business. Look at yourself. You're the problem. Why do you make us do this? You should have just shut down on your own. You should have been a responsible individual. Don't you love your grandma and to be open and try to survive and to make ends meet for your family? You open up and you threaten the lives of elderly people. You see, that's what's happening here. Is we have seen in full effect the progressive dream. Socialism at its finest. At its finest. and it's ruined us. Unemployment skyrocketed. Companies destroyed, desolated. And it's your fault. It's not theirs. It's never their fault. It's never their fault. It's never the abusive person's fault in their own eyes. And they're doing the same thing. They're making it feel like it's your fault. And I'm here to tell you, maybe you did have a bad business, maybe you didn't, but you cannot expect or plan for the government to shut down for 6 months, for them to shut down the economy, and expect you to survive. You can't expect anyone to survive. People could have great businesses. And the sleight of hand that is being done here under the guise of entrepreneurship, small business, entrepreneur.com after all, the small business article publication where small businesses, entrepreneurs read all the time. And they're using as examples mighty retailers, once mighty retailers, and chain restaurants, guys. Do you see the sleight of hand that's going on? They're communicating to an entrepreneur, small business audience, and they're saying, COVID, this is the title, COVID-19 didn't kill your business, you did. And then the case in point is big business. Why would you do this? Because they have to protect their own. And the only way they can do that is blame you. It's never their fault. It's never the abusive partner's fault. And I just want to tell you guys that you're not crazy. You're right. We are in an abusive relationship. The government is abusive to us. They're overstepping their bounds. They're taking what's not theirs by force. And you're not crazy, guys. It doesn't work. And we need to fight against it. We can't be the silent majority. We'll talk to you tomorrow. God bless.